Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston. Flight controllers here led by Flight Director Emily Nelson with Robert Hanley talking to the crew as the spacecraft communicator are busy watching over the systems aboard the orbiting outpost as the Expedition 31 crew continues to cruise around the globe right now. Altitude of 250 statute miles over the Pacific Ocean off the western coast of South America on a northeasterly track. Commander Oleg Kononenko and his Russian colleagues, Gennady Padalka and Sergey Revin, and the NASA astronauts Joe Acaba and Don Pettit, and European Space Station Agency astronaut Andre Kuipers, all continuing midway through their workday, having just completed a lunch and having a conversation with students in Philadelphia as part of the Destination Imagination activities.
See, life is good on the space station. We don't have to do laundry, and we don't have to take showers. So, no, we don't take showers up here because, like you said, the water would just float away, and it would be a big mess. And like Andre mentioned earlier, water is very precious.
Today, the crew is working with a variety of different scientific experiments and getting ready for their return home, at least for three of those crew members. Don Pettit today working with the miscible fluids in microgravity experiment, while he also did some power troubleshooting issues with the spheres, the synchronized position hold and engage and rendezvous experiment. Joe Acaba is replacing some components in the multi-user droplet combustion apparatus. That's part of the combustion integrated rack, which is used to study flames and fire and extinguishment in space. Acaba also working to do some change outs in the holding tanks and the wastewater storage tank that is used by the water recovery system and its urine processor assembly, which is used to recycle urine into good drinking water for the space station crew. He's also been doing some work on the advanced resistive exercise device. Yesterday was a day for greasing the rails that are used to have the momentum arms travel up and down so that the crew can mimic weightlifting even when there is no gravity. Also a couple of medical experiments going on and a lot of pre-packing for the upcoming departure of Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit. Pettit today is starting his second full year in space. Yesterday marked 365 days all told for Don Pettit in orbit. He's getting ready to come home with Oleg Kononenko and Andre Kuipers. The change of command ceremony for all that is scheduled for Friday. Oleg Kononenko will hand over command to Gennady Padalka. That's scheduled to happen at 6:35 p.m. on NASA TV. And then Saturday night, very late, we'll have the undocking of the Soyuz TMA-03M spacecraft from the Rosvet module. And Kononenko, Pettit, and Kuipers on board there will undock at 11:48 p.m. Central Time, and then follow that up with a landing on the steppe of Kazakhstan at 3:14 a.m. Central Time, which works out to 2:14 p.m. Kazakhstan time.